What is the importance of organisations like Rain Dance?
Well, it's, I mean, tonight is obviously about bringing all people together from the indie film scene in Britain. And obviously, you know, it's a small cottage industry, so it's really important that everyone gets to meet each other, because the only way you can get a film made is by being a part of a team and bringing together people that you know and collaborating. And whether that be a friend of mine writes a script and, oh, I know someone that's got some money, or an actor that it would be perfect for. It's things like this that are really important just to bring those people together. And, you know, Raindance has been a part of the UK scene for so long now that you know, it's kind of, it's almost the spine of it. So, you know, it's a great setup that they've got. Well, I mean, I've always been of the train of thought that films should be entertainment. You know, there are some films that are obviously, you know, teaching people something or opening their eyes to the world or whatever the message is. But at the end of the day, films are about escapism and giving people a peek into another world. So the difference between commercial and independent, I'm not sure should be a difference. If it's commercial, it means people are going to see it and they've paid for their ticket, which means the investors get their money back, which means those investors might want to invest again in the next film, whether it be the same filmmakers or whether it be someone else. So I would stray away from sort of having them as two separate worlds. They should absolutely be together. As someone very famous once said, you know, if you're going to make a film for just yourself and your mother, then, you know, don't enter the film industry. Just get a camera and shoot it for you and your mother. At the end of the day, as a filmmaker, you've got a big responsibility, not just to the people you're working with and the people that are going to sell the film eventually, but also, more importantly perhaps, to the people that put money in. You know, they've coined that money into the bank account, and you really have a responsibility to make sure that at least they get most, if not all, of their money back. And who knows, if they have a profit, fantastic stuff. Because it just means more films will get made. If no film ever makes money, and this is the problem of piracy, if no film ever makes money, people will stop investing. So, yeah, let's not sort of separate indie and commercial.
We still, the old way is just out on DVD now. What excited you about getting the chance to keep that franchise going, and to hopefully, I think we're doing a third one as well now, aren't we?
Yeah, no, a third one's been talked about. It was just so wonderful working with the actors. Danny Boy's here, actually. He was the villain in the first one. But, I mean, the older boys, who obviously will be part of the franchise throughout, are just such a joy to work with. A, they're complete professionals. They've seen it all. They've done it all. But the joy and the happiness that you have working with those people, they're so delighted to get back on set in leading roles. And let's not forget that. You know, recently Morgan Freeman and Michael Caine did a similar kind of vibe to the old way movies, and they were just ranting about how brilliant it was being a lead in a movie instead of being, you know, the mentor figure or the father figure or a guy that turns up and gets killed straight away. So it was lovely working with Ian and Chris and Tony and Jimmy Cosmo on the first one, and that's what I really wanted to bring to the second one, was open up, because I was very deliberate in the first one in the script not to suggest that there was only four guys in the gang. I wanted this to be not quite a Marvel universe, but, you know, the Archer gang could be ever spreading, and you just bring in more and more people. And certainly in the second one, it was Steal the Old Way, fantastic. Patrick Bergen involved, who was the original leader of the Archer gang, you know, who's the boss man back in the day, and Julian Glover's obviously one of the villains in that. So it's just, as I say, it's just a joy working with these guys. They know what they're doing. They have amazing anecdotes. I love Julian Glover forever. His chair was too low, so I got down on my knees and started building up the chair so it wasn't too low behind the desk. And he just turned to everyone and goes, oh, he's like a young Spielberg. That, for me, was a moment, because obviously he worked with him on Last Crusade. So I was like, yes, okay, I will work with you forevermore. So, yeah, it's that was the main thrust behind Old Way. And, you know, it's just fun having old guys cracking, you know, cracking jokes and smack, you know, cracking skulls as well. Well, my plans would be to make these forevermore until, you know, obviously the cast start leaving our fair planet. In terms of what the third one will be and where it's going, there's lots of ideas being bandied about. And, you know, again, calendars and diaries and things like that, it might come to play that I won't even be involved at any point in it, which would be a massive shame, because I love the franchise that I've built and I love working with those guys. So, but we'll see. The future is another planet.